Hey guys, I'm Pixel Dan, and this is a review of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles Out of the Shadows City Sewer Lair playset. That's right, we're taking a look at the third Sewer Lair playset that has been released in this new line of Ninja Turtles. Now, this one specifically is branded for the Out of the Shadows movie. But I've taken a look at two other giant sewer playsets just like this in the last couple years here. So it's kind of amazing that we've got now a third sewer home playset. So what about this is different than the others? Well, that is what we're going to take a look at here today. First things first, let's talk about the packaging and everything. It comes in a large scale box, very similar to what we've seen in the past. It does feature some brand new artwork on there of the playset and a bunch of the characters on there. Really cool. I always love seeing the artwork on these boxes. I think that is a lot of fun. When you open up the box, there are a ton of pieces inside. There's a sheet of instructions that will guide you through the process of putting it together. Kids will definitely need their parents' help to do this. Also worth noting, there is a sheet of stickers, several stickers for this. Put the stickers on the pieces before you assemble the playset. That is very important. It'll be really hard to put some of these stickers on once the playset is put together. After you spend some time putting it together, I think I took maybe 20 to 30 minutes to do it. I took my time with it, but this right here is what I ended up with. This massive new playset that stands over 40 inches tall. This thing is huge, and it's kind of crazy because I have three of these giant things now. Where am I going to put it? I don't know. So like I said, this here is specifically themed for the new Out of the Shadows movie. And you might look at it and think, well, it looks just like the exact same place that we've already got. But one thing that Playmates did with this one is they added quite a few new things. They incorporated a lot of new features and design elements to really change this one up and make it feel a lot different than the ones we had in the past. The second version was basically the exact same playset, just with some different colors and some included sounds. This one here reworks a lot of things. Let's go ahead and start down here underground at the sewer lair part itself, just so I can show you some of the differences. First of all, this whole bottom platform down here is different. You can see it's designed a lot different than what we had before. We do still have this little indention in here where there are some stickers that look like water. I do kind of like how it actually looks like water this time and not like green ooze. It makes more sense that we have like some sewer water in here. You can see it's got a really great kind of brick motif here. And if you come over here on this side, you'll notice we have this really large screen TV here, and there's a little chair. So it's a monitor or a TV, I don't know, either way. But it rotates, you can see you can swivel that around, and you also have a little chair down here. So for example, if I want to take one of my turtles, we'll bring Mikey over here. He likes watching the TV, right? You can set your turtles right there, put them in front of the screen. They go, ah! Oh, we got to stand them back up. There you go. Get on that chair, Mikey. But it shows you right there how they can kind of hang out in front of the TV or the screen, or, you know, I don't know exactly what's going on here, but you can see it's got a nice sticker on there. So it's got a cool little decal going on. Up here, we have the same platform. Now, one thing that you really notice, the base is different. The back part right here is what is really the same about this playset. So this whole orange brick area on the back features a lot of the exact same action features as what we saw before. So for instance, if you come back down here, you'll notice, hey, hello, we got this little hole right here that you can see through. There's a nice little ladder on the back that can fold up. It can clip into place. You can lower that down if you want to. That way you can have your turtles climb up the ladder and stand on this little ledge back here, just like we've seen in the past. One new thing back here is this cool little elevator. You see this? Got a nice little platform that moves up and down. And there is a nice peg on here. So, you know, we got the little peg right here. And we can slide them up, which brings them up to the surface. Instead of being in the pizza restaurant like we had before, you can see we've actually got like a Madison Square Gardens kind of thing up here, which is kind of cool. Although I do love the stickers where the turtles have apparently graffitied all over it. So it's not actually MSG. Kind of fun stuff there. All right, let's come back down below the surface before we keep talking about the top. Just a few more things that you've seen before already. We do have another ledge up here on the back. You can see we've got the little spinning wall here just like before. It does reveal a little keyboard and a screen. There's no stickers on it. It's just plain yellow. But it's like a little hidden compartment there. So you can swivel that around. We just have a brick wall. And then we've got that fun little stuff here.
Down here is a new little ledge. You can see it's very cool looking. It's a bright green. It's got the little paper lanterns, which I really think is a cool touch. Really nice little base there that you can stand your turtles on. You can see it's nice and wide. Got a new place to stand them, which is pretty cool. So that's a new little area right there. And then if you come back down to that main ledge, you will notice that we do still have the sliding doors. The little display in the back there, like the cardboard bits that where it looks like you can see into the room. It's different this time. It's not the little tree that you saw on the Nick Turtles line. But again, the doors slide open. What's up, guys? And you can open that up back there. You know, so then, I don't know, we can have like Master Splinter come through. You can hang out like that. You can stand them on the ledge right there, or you know, you can come back in here, close those doors right up. So really fun feature. Again, very similar to what we've seen in the past. Now let's direct your attention over this direction. This right here is another brand new area. And one of the things that I really like, you might notice this little roadway right here with kind of like a little speed bump, authorized personnel only. I really like this. This right here is specifically designed for your turtle tactical truck to drive right through. Look at that. How cool is that? They actually have a parking space for the new turtle truck. That is fantastic, because that way we can play with them together, we can display them together. I really thought this was a very nice touch for this brand new play set. And then just to kind of move that out of the way so we can get a better look over here off to the side. In the past, this is always where Donnie's workstation has been. And you can see it's kind of the same thing. It is designed a little bit differently this time. The keyboard and the screens can swivel, so you can rotate those however you want to. And that way you've got a station for Donatello to do some work. I love all the multiple screens right there. So pretty cool stuff. So that is what it looks like below the surface. Now you might have noticed that in the center here on this pillar, instead of having the stairs like we had before, we've got this green sewer tube slide. I gotta tell you, I love this. This right here makes it feel a lot like that vintage sewer home playset that had those green pipes. I thought that was a really cool touch. And if you come up here to the surface, we have the same manhole cover where if we press the little button, it drops down and it basically leads you to this slide instead. So I guess, you know, April's ready to go down and see the turtles. Woo! She can just go down the slide and come right down into the water if she wants to. Of course, that'd be a great entrance for your turtles there too. That is really cool. I thought that was just such a fun feature. And again, it feels like a great throwback to the vintage Turtles line. Now over here on the surface, we do have some things that are the same as before. We do still have the little bucket over here. It doesn't have any paint or stickers. It's just bright blue this time. But this is, of course, an area where if you've got some ooze or some slime, you can put it in the bucket. It'll dump down into the little pipe here. And then you could spill that however you want to. Now, just like in the past, it's the exact same pipe, which means it's going to drain really slow. And I've shown this on past reviews. I'm not going to do it today. So you'll have to check out some of my older videos to see exactly how that works. It's exactly the same feature. So let's talk about the back over here again. I kind of mentioned the subway station, how it looked like Madison Square Gardens with the graffiti. I love this. This is a really great new backer piece right here that makes it seem like something different than the pizza shop we always saw. It's got a really great New York-y feel. I do find it kind of funny that the turtles are graffitiing all over the place. That doesn't seem like a very heroic thing to do, but it's still funny because it totally covers up where it says Madison Square Gardens and stuff. I thought that was pretty clever. I love the pizza poster here. Again, something that feels very classic or very vintage for the turtles. We've got this great little police line, which you could put anywhere you want to. I just thought that was a nice little included accessory. I'm just dropping it down the sewer hole here, but you can put that anywhere. I mean, it doesn't even have to go here. You can just use it while you're playing. That was a fun little accessory. And then you might notice that instead of the dumpster, we've got a food cart, a street vendor selling food, something that you would actually see in New York City. I thought that was a really cool feature. And also, this incorporates that really cool classic pizza throwing accessory. So I want to point this out. We do have these little discs here that's got the pizzas. There are seven or eight of them. I believe there's eight of them in there. I lost count there. We've got eight of these little red discs. For some reason, there are only six stickers to actually make them in the pizzas. So two of your red discs aren't going to have toppings. I'm not sure exactly what happened there. But regardless, you can fill the discs up here in the top, and then by pressing this button right here on the side, ba-doo, 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 you can launch pizzas out of it, which is pretty fantastic. It is kind of funny that they just shoot off to the side, but it's perfect for, like, you know, I guess firing at the Technodrome or, you know, anything like that that's coming at you. So really fun stuff, and I thought that was something different than having the same old dumpster once again. Now, you do have a nice platform up here on the top, too. It's just empty, so you know you can stand your turtles up here. And that is definitely one of the things that this playset is really good about having. Lots of display space. I mean, you can just put your action figures all over this thing, whether they're on the top at the street level, whether they're down in the actual sewer home. There are platforms all over the place. There are figures diving off of it. I'm just knocking things down. there's platforms all over the place. There's lots of little pegs, so if you want to stand them on there and you don't want them to move, you can pop them on there. If not, you can just stand them on the platforms. It's really, really nice. And then, of course, we got to talk about the cardboard backer here. This is, of course, a new backer, again, to fit the theme of the movie. It's got a more realistic-looking cityscape here in the background. It's shaped a little different. It actually stretches all the way across and connects over here, which is really cool. And if you look at the tip top, you can see the new Technodrome kind of hovering over the city, about to cause some destruction. So, pretty cool. It's neat having a new scene there. But that is pretty much it, you guys. This is the brand new City Sewer Lair playset. All right, guys, it's comparison time. All right, so I'm only bringing up one of the previously released sewer homes, but that's because these two versions were very similar to each other, so I don't really feel like we have to have all three of them up here, plus I just don't have the space for it. But this was the version, the second release out there. So you can see them standing side by side here, and you can kind of tell that we do have quite a few differences in their overall designs with the features. The backing is the same, the street level part down here, like the ground level, is the same, but the bases are a lot different. You can really see that there's actually a lot more base space on this new playset compared to the other one down here. And I love this entryway with the car here. You can see the difference with the stairs and the green piping. So between these two, there's actually quite a bit of differences. They're not just the exact same playset. Sure, they are built on the same kind of base, but they're very different. There's actually a lot of features that are different between the two. So there you go, my friends. That is the City Sewer Lair playset, part of the brand new TMNT Out of the Shadows lineup. This is honestly a really fantastic playset. It really is. I've been a big fan of this playset in all its incarnations. And like I said, this is the third time we're basically getting the same style playset, but this one does have a lot of new features on it that I feel like it could warrant a new purchase. Especially if you've never picked one up before, this is a really great one. It might actually be my favorite of the three. Maybe I'm saying that because it's new and it feels a little fresh, but there's a lot on this that I really like. I thought that the pizza thrower thing on the top was a cool touch. I absolutely adore that there's a place to actually park the turtle's truck or your turtle van or whatever figures you want to use this for. And that's what's so great about this. Even though it does have this movie-themed cardboard backer with this Technodrome on there, this playset is still nice enough that if you don't want to display it with your movie figures, you can display it with your Nick Turtles. You can display it with your vintage Turtles. It's just a really great display piece and a really fun playset. Kids are going to love it, and old-timey fans like me, I think they're going to love it too. So there you go, guys. I got to give a special thanks to Playmates Toys for sending this along so I can get a chance to look at it out of the box. I'm very grateful for that. These are hitting store shelves right now for the new movie, which is also in theaters. So happy hunting, my friends. And hey, guys, if you enjoyed this video, why not hit that like button and also subscribe? That way you never miss out on one of my Turtles reviews. What are you guys waiting for? Get to it. Hit that subscribe button. Until next time, my friends.